हरि ओम। ग्लैड टू बी हियर टू रिफ्लेक्ट अगेन ऑन दिस सीरीज ऑफ रमणास आत्मविचार। एज अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस आत्मविचार, व्हेन people try to meditate, one of the frequent and common complaint is that it's difficult to bring the mind to a standstill. They say mind is hard to conquer. Then also people read about Manunasham, the mind should be destroyed. So then people find it hard and difficult to go about controlling the mind and destroy the mind. So it's a common and a frequent complaint by the seekers. Now let's try to see what Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi has to say about the mind in Upadesa Sara and Upadesa Undiyar. We are going to look at the stanza number 17 in both of these texts. Let me share the text with you all now. Manasam tu kim margane krite नैव मानसं मार्गे आर्जवात् मानसं तु किं मार्गने कृते नैव मानसं मार्गे आर्जवात् दट् इस् द स्टन्जा फ्रोम् उपदेशसार एण्ड् नौ आन् द उपदेश उन्दियर् मनदिन् उरुवै मरवादु उसाव மனம் என ஒன்றில்லை உந்திப்பர மார்க்கம் நேரார்க்கும் உந்திப்பர மனம் மனதின் உருவை மறவாதுசாவ மனம் என ஒன்றில்லை உந்திப்பர மார்க்கம் நேரார்க்கும் உந்திப்பர ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த டெக்ஸ்ட் விச் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு ரிஃப்ளெக்ட் ஆன் நவ் ஸோ ஹியர் அஸ் ஐ செட் த கம்ப்ளைண்ட் இஸ் அபவுட் மைண்ட் how to bring the mind to a standstill, how to control the mind. And then they talk about mano nasham. How do you get rid of the mind or how do you destroy the mind? Now, Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi says, manasam tu kim. So what is this mind? Marge, margane krite. And when you inquire in this manner as to what is this mind? Where is this mind? When you go about inquiring about the mind, Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi says, naiva manasam, you will discover there is no such thing called mind. And he says, marge arjavat, and this is the direct, straightforward path. So, to control the mind, to conquer the mind, Bhagavan's answer is, inquire as to what is this mind. And when you inquire about it, you will discover there is no such thing called mind. And he also says, this is the direct path. So same thing in Tamil also, manadin uruvai maravadu usava, meaning try, you know, without giving up, constantly find out what this mind is. Maravadu sava. Manamena undrilai. There is no such thing called mind. And he says, Margam Nirak. This is the straight path. Okay. So this is what Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi says. And what is our experience? We are here grappling with the mind, trying to control it. And when we think we have controlled it, then it shows its capabilities. You try to destroy it, and you are trying to deal with this mind. And here Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi says, when you truly inquire what is this mind, you will discover that there is no such thing called mind. Now, this is what Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi say, what he is saying is contradictory and contrary to our experience. We here are struggling with the mind, and Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi says there is no such thing called mind. So which of this is true? Naturally, Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi is a great saint. Definitely you have to try to understand what he is trying to say instead of rejecting it just because it is contrary to our experience. So, what is this inquiry about this mind? What is this mind? So, it is said, mind is nothing but the procession of thoughts. So, when you talk about procession of thoughts, a thought arises and then the thought subsides. Then there's another thought arises and that thought subsides, and on and on and on. And this procession of thoughts is what is referred to as mind. So, if you look at it, at any given time, one thought arises and that dies, and another thought arises and that dies. So, nothing there is permanent. This is the first thing. So, if you talk about mind, mind is nothing about the procession of thoughts. And the procession of thoughts is actually individual thoughts. Each thought arises and dies. So, nothing there which is permanent. Not a single thought is permanent. So, whatever comes, it goes. So, it's not real. It's there, it's momentary. Every thought is a momentary thought. And what we do is that we regard it as real. This is the mistake we make when we try to fight with the mind. Instead of understanding that it is something which is unreal, which is impermanent, and it arises and it subsides, we think that it is real. We think that it is always there, and therefore we try to fight with it. So, basically, it is like fighting with something which doesn't exist. That's why we have to struggle so much. The more we fight, more we will struggle. What Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi says is, when you inquire like this, what you will discover is that there is no such thing called mind, meaning the mind is not real. It is made up of thoughts, and each thought is momentary. It comes and it goes. And to the one to whom it comes and goes, is always there. To the one to whom it comes and goes, he is always there. What comes and goes is very momentary. And as such, we have to regard it as unreal and let it come, let it go, instead of fighting with it. So, understanding that this is impermanent, this comes and this goes, without lending it the reality, we should see it as something which comes and goes, and therefore it is not real. When we develop this attitude, then what will happen is, then when we do not give importance to the thoughts, because we understand the impermanent and fickle nature of these thoughts, momentary nature of these thoughts. So something which is momentary, something which is fickle, something which changes every second, we should not regard that as real. We should not regard that as me, because we make up these thoughts and think that this is me. My idea, my notion of who I am is made up of these thoughts. But these thoughts are very fickle and they are so momentary. And we are sitting here and try to make it real, and then we try to fight with it. So what Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi says is, please understand the fickle and momentary nature of these thoughts. And this is what we refer to as mind. And it is not permanent, and therefore it is not real. And therefore, let it come, let it go, and then it will not have any hold on us. And this is why he says, this is the direct approach. Meaning, to whom this comes and goes, that is you, are always there. The thoughts come and go. But we behave as if the thoughts which come and go, which we call the mind, which is always there, and that is more powerful than us. So that which is there all along, always, is more powerful than that which comes and goes for a moment. But we think the other way. That which comes and goes for a moment is more powerful, and we are powerless. So this we need to understand very clearly. That which comes and goes, which is there only for a moment, which is fickle, it cannot be powerful. It is not real. And therefore, we being there always, we being more powerful than that, there is no need to even fight with it. You just ignore it, it goes. When we develop this attitude, then one can transcend the thoughts and transcend the mind. Because what we are doing in the name of transcending the thoughts and transcending the mind is that we are understanding the unreal nature of them, and after that we are refusing to regard them as real. We are refusing to lend reality to it. And that's the way one comes to realize one's own self by transcending the mind.
Om Namo Bhagavate Sri Ramanaya.